गुड मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम नूतन गुप्ता सेंडिंग द वीडियो ऑफ SST चैप्टर क्लाइमेट वीडियो नंबर 3. इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट टू फैक्टर्स विच अफेक्ट द क्लाइमेट वर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द इक्वेटर एंड हाइट अबव द सी लेवल. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस थर्ड फैक्टर विच इफेक्ट क्लाइमेट इज डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सी. Water heats up and cools more slowly than land. This affects the climate of the places near the sea. They are warmer in winter and cooler in summer than places far away from the sea. For example, Mumbai is closer to the equator than Delhi. We can therefore expect it to be warmer than Delhi during summer. But this is not so, because Mumbai is situated on the sea coast. This makes its climate moderate. Now listen. Usually water takes more to be cool or warm in comparison of land. This thing affects the climate of the near to the sea or water bodies. Those places which are near to the sea or water bodies, they are hotter in winter and cooler in summer as comparison to places far away from the sea. Example, Mumbai. As you know, the climate of Mumbai is moderate, which is neither extremely hot nor extremely cold. In comparison of most of the cities of Delhi, UP, which is not near to the sea. Mumbai is closer to the equator as compared to Delhi. So you might be thinking that Mumbai would be warmer than Delhi, but this is not so, because Mumbai has a large coastline along the Arabian Sea, which makes its climate moderate. Now we will discuss the another factor affecting climate is winds. Now read the chapter. Winds tend to flow in particular direction in different parts of the world. They may be hot, cool, or full of moisture, depending where they come from. For example, the monsoon winds from the Indian Ocean and Arabian Sea bring rain to large parts of India. The hot wind from the Thar Desert make Delhi very hot during summer. Thus, the climate of an area is affected by the winds. Now, another factor which is affect the climate is wind. Prevailing wind bring air from one type of climate to another. Do you know what is the wind? First, we will discuss the wind. The fast flowing air is known as wind. Winds always flow in fixed direction in different parts of the world. These winds can be hot, cold, dry, and filled with the moisture, depending on their origin or place where they come from. The way air move affect the climate, because winds move heat and cold temperatures as well as moisture from one place to another. For example, the monsoon winds from the Indian Ocean and Arabian Sea bring rain to large parts of India. The hot wind come from the Thar Desert makes Delhi very hot during summer. Thus, the climate of an area is affected by the winds. In this picture, you can see that the wind comes from Indian Ocean, which will be full of moisture, which will further form the cloud and bring the rain, and these wind moves to India. Now, next factor of the affecting climate is humidity. So let's read the chapter. Humidity is amount of water vapor in the air. It affects the climate of a place. The air over the equator is laden with the water vapor. as the heat of the sun causes rapid evaporation of the ocean waters. This causes heavy rain in the area. So the climate near the equator is hot and wet. Deserts are formed in the place where there is very little humidity and so very little rain throughout the year. Let's discuss the last climate factor, humidity. First, I want to ask the question, what is the humidity? Humidity is the amount of water vapor in the air. It also affects the climate of a place, air which comes from equator including with the water vapor. Because the heat of the sun increases rapid evaporation of the ocean water. So the climate near the equator is hot and wet. And where there is no water vapor in the air, or little humidity on the land are formed as desert. And there will be very little rain throughout the year. Nowadays we can see that rain is going on and air is full of moisture. So it's automatic changed in humidity. It is the water vapor content stays the same and the temperature drops. The relative humidity increases. If the water vapor content stays the same and the temperature rises, the relative humidity decreases. So this is it because colder air does not require as much as moisture to become saturated as warmer air. Now we will discuss the did you know. In this did you know, we come to know about who called the meteorologist. Scientists who study the predict the weather are called meteorologist. Predict to tell what is going to happen in the future. Scientists जिन लोग ये पता करते हैं कि future में क्या होने वाला है, उनको वेदर के बारे में क्या होने वाला है, उनको हम क्या बोलते हैं, मेट्रियोलॉजिस्ट. दे ऑफन यूज सैटेलाइट पिक्चर्स ऑफ द अर्थ टू प्रेडिक्ट द वेदर. यू मे हैव सीन सच सैटेलाइट पिक्चर ऑन वेदर बुलेटिन ऑन द टेलीविजन. दिस इज द पिक्चर, अ सैटेलाइट जनरेटेड वेदर मैप ऑफ द साउथ ईस्ट एशिया. थैंक यू. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो we will discuss the exercise of the book. Now homework. Homework is project work. Work in a group, find out the weather report for your city from the newspaper, TV or internet. Do this every day for a month. Note it down in your scrapbook. Note the daily changes in maximum and minimum temperature, humidity, cloud and rain. What was the highest temperature for that month? Second, what was the lowest temperature? Third was how much of the rain fell or was it dry month with no rainfall? Third one is what was the percentage of the humidity? And next is based on these report, can you say what the season is? And last is find out about the climate of the place where you stay. Thank you.